Hello, my beautiful people. It is a marvelous, magnificent Monday. Today's motivational moment is all about giving Christmas gifts. Now, I'm not talking about giving gifts to you or me. No, I'm talking about giving gifts to Jesus Christ. Have you ever wondered what Jesus would want? What kind of gift that Jesus would want from you or me? Have you ever wondered? Have you ever wondered what you could give Jesus for Christmas? We have commercialized Christmas so much that we have really forgotten the true meaning of what Christmas is, what it's all about. And for that fact, who it's all about, which is Jesus Christ. We think it's all about the gift giving and the spending all this money and going into debt that, you know, spending money that we don't have. And then the next year, we're trying our best to pay it off, everything that we spent for every person that we're trying to impress or whatever with a gift, with the money that we don't actually have. Well, think about it. What would you give the Savior of the world? What could he possibly want from us? Well, in Luke 21, there was a story that Jesus tells about a poor woman. And you probably know this story, or you remember the story. You know that she brought him so much joy. The chapter begins the story with Jesus taking note of the wealthy. And all of these wealthy people were placing, you know, their gifts and everything they had, you know, at the altar for Jesus. All of this riches and wealth that they had. But they were doing it for commercialism, of course, you know, because they were trying to show how rich they were and, you know, looking back and making sure everybody noticed what they were placing on the table. But in the midst of that all, there was a poor lady, a poor widow. And, you know, I can just imagine this poor widow slowly walking up through the crowd, embarrassed probably. Her clothes were probably torn. She didn't have on the richest of sandals like the rich, wealthy people did, you know. And people were probably mocking at her, wondering where is she going? What is she going to lay at the altar for Jesus? What is she going to bring? She doesn't have anything, you know. She even fumbled trying to get her two pieces of mite out to give to Jesus, you know, and a tear fell down her face, you know, as she shuffles by the arrogant aristocrats, you know, trying to mock her, you know. I wonder if she was doubting herself, doubting her gift, as the people were watching her, trying to get her little two pieces of gift out to give to Jesus. And they were placing all of this gold and silver and all this clanging that they had together as they swayed proudly, you know. Did she feel like her gift was worthless and meaningless? Who would notice two little mites among all of these wealthy pieces that the people were putting up there? Who would even notice that? But I'm going to tell you, my brothers and sisters, Jesus noticed her. Jesus noticed those two little pieces of mite that she put up there. Jesus did. He noticed it because she gave from her soul. She gave from her heart. She gave from her poverty, everything that she had to Jesus. You know, even though she thought it wasn't much, Jesus knew it was her all. So he noticed it. So it wasn't that the people were noticing it. It was for Jesus to notice it. So did you catch that? The widow gave out of her poverty. And Jesus says that is much more than what the wealthy had given. That was much more. The amount she gave, those two mites, were two small copper coins. In the economy of that day, they were barely worth anything. A mite was the smallest coin at that time. It was the smallest coin. It held the lowest value of coins. But the widow gave the lowest amount of money possible. She gave the least that she could, that anybody could, but that was all that she had. But what did she do? She didn't spend it. She gave it to Jesus. She gave out of her brokenness. What she gave was probably the thing that held the most worth to her. And others would see it as not much of anything. Wow, wow, wow. But Jesus saw something different in her. He saw that she gave so much more than the wealthy could ever have given. She gave what others would frown at, which was nothing to them, but was so much to God. She gave out of her broken life, a broken soul. And I think Jesus longs for that kind of gift for us all. He doesn't want the fakeness. He doesn't want us, our pridefulness. He doesn't want our richfulness coming to him faking, like we're all this and that, just to show others what we have given God. He wants our brokenness. He wants us to show him our brokenness, our wholeness, our whole soul. That's what Jesus wants for us this Christmas and every day. He wants the real you, the real me. Do you hear what I'm saying? He wants the real you and the real me. So this Christmas, think about giving the real you to Jesus. That real brokenness. Not the fake you, but the real you, the whole and the broken. This woman invested her livelihood into her offering. Now, shouldn't we do the same thing? Shouldn't we do the same thing? Should we not invest our livelihood into our offering to Jesus? Should we not live our lives fully and completely devoted to him? Not to us, not to others, not to showing off for others, but showing off for Jesus. And not caring what the next person thinks or says, but showing Jesus our true brokenness. That is what will bring God and Jesus our true, his true joy. That will bring him the true joy for Christmas. So if you're thinking and you're wondering what to give Jesus for Christmas, give him the real you. Give him that real brokenness of you. Come to him the real way, that realness. Leave the fakeness outside, but come to him with the whole you. And I guarantee you, it will be a much better Christmas. That's the real meaning of Christmas. Not about the gift giving, not about the buying all this gift, spending all the money. But Jesus is the real meaning of the season. And we have gotten out of that and we have forgotten that. And Jesus just wants the real you. So remember that, my friends. Keep smiling, sharing those smiles, being the best you that you can be. Remember, each day, do something to grow yourself. Until next time, this is D-Vibes signing off.